Okay, yo se la. Welcome to Rifki the Cyber. In this video, I would like to explain it to you about SS7 protocol in the telecommunications. Usually, in my previous video, I always explain telecommunications, but mainly is exposure to the radio frequency part. But this now, SS7 is mainly used in the core network. Although, right now it's already become 4G and 5G, everything is evolved from the SS7. Some of them is already made, some of them is already used the diameter. This topic is the one of the recommendations from someone in this comment. So the comment saying that, can I make video about the SS7 attack? I would like to avoid the wording of attack. Goal of this video is mainly this is the part one. I would like to help you to give the SS7 protocol start. How is it look like? And the handshake, the SCTP handshake, etc. And preparations of how we want to running the SS7 SIGTRAN using the anytime interrogations from our laptop. So later in the part two, the part one, the theory and also the preparations for that one. In this case, for the SS7, we don't using the TCP/IP. We will use the HTTP, like Stream Control Transportation Protocol. I think that is the abbreviations. So day to day, when we browsing the internet, we usually common daily is using the TCP/IP. But for the SIGTRAN, usually is using the HTTP. In the daily common practice, usually when we are browsing or we do some handshake with the HTTP, we are using the TCP/IP protocol in the transport layer of IP. But the SIGTRAN commonly used with the HTTP is a Stream Control Transportation Protocol. This protocol have another advantage that they have features for the multi-homing. So the protocol itself, they can read. For example, they will have more than one endpoints, and once one of the more the one endpoint, let's say from the heartbeat, they not giving the acknowledge, then is immediately seamlessly go to another endpoints. But this is in the transport layer, yeah. This is really the native feature of the HTTP, one of them. And in the TCP/IP, usually handshakes will be, for example, this is a client and this is a server. And the server is switched off, and then the server switch on, and then the port listen, and then the client start the applications. They will sending the handshake with the sync sending the SYN sync request, and then the server will replay to the client. Okay, sync ACK, synchronous with the acknowledge, and then from the client giving back again, okay, I acknowledge already receiving your SYN plus SEK, and then both is established. SCTP is not like that. SCTP is have a different dialogue for establish. Is using the init from the server, from the client sending to server init, and then they replay with the init SEK, and then after that they client sending the echo, and then they give it back the echo SEK. That is the HTTP. And the SS7 protocol is contained like transport layer from the HTTP itself. And then after that, there is MTP level. After MTP, there's a SCCP level. Yeah. In the MTP level, will be explained the point code. Network indicator is in the MTP level. Point code is the addressing. But that is like not the point code is like, I guarantee the point code is like our LAN IP in the host, which is in, if your host you have 192.168.1 dot something, possible also in the other side they have 192.168.1 dot something. That is a point code, and also there is a network indicator, etc. there. And in the SCCP is addressing using, we can see the addressing using the global title, wise global title manner. Global title is like public IP. Yeah, but it's a full digital, and the convention is look like our phone number, guys, with the 62 or 44 something like that if the UK, etc. etc. Yeah, so I guaranteed the global title is unique. There is no global title is the same in the whole world. Yeah, okay. And also in the SCCP level, I was explained about MTP with the point code, with the network indicator. And also in the SCCP, there is addressing of the global title. Also in the SCCP, we can see also the subsystem number. What is the subsystem number? Is it 6? 6, that mean I'm HLR. If this is a subsystem number 8, that mean Mobile Switching Center, MSC. Yeah. 146, CAMEL. That's reflected in the SCCP level. And also in the SCCP level, there is also of NADI, Nature of Address Indicator. We can see there, is it unknown, national, or international of the NADI, from for those NADI. And then above of that, above the SCCP, there is a TCAP, Transport Capability Application part. Normally, if the ISO protocol after SCCP is directly ISO, but the GSM map, we will learning about map SS718 and time interrogations is running on top of the TCAP, Transport Capability and Application part. From the TCAP, we can see, let's say for example, ASEAN entries, application application contact entries. So we can see for example, if this is any time interrogations, what any time interrogations in the version, is it version 3, version 2, anytime interrogation info? What is the SRI? Is it SRI version 2 or version 1? We can see that from the TCAP easily. And on top of that, in the application part, there is a map, mobile application part. It can be CAMEL, can be CAP, CAMEL application part, but in this case, SS7, anytime interrogations, also like provider subscriber info, or for example, send routing info, anytime interrogations, those is classified in the map mobile application part. We can see that from the TS29.002. That is a 3GP standard. I repeat, 3GPP TS29.002. You can Google it, download the PDF, you can learn it by yourself. So those is the protocol stack that I already explained it to you, and I already explained it to you. The handshakes between the SCTP, yeah, so SCTP, MTP, SCCP, TCAP, and then mobile application part. I already explained the stacks, and normally the SS7 is running in the core network. I don't want to using the word attack. I just want to give you how we can running it from here, the request, SS7 request. So if ever there is some project, you know how to do that. How you know how to running, and you have a client of the SS7. So rather than a lot of chatty for this part one, let's prepare it first. Don't miss for the video part two, because in the part two we will try to run, and we will go through of those from the trace file. Rather than a lot of talk, let's actions, guys. Okay, first thing we will. Something that I would like to say to you also, read me here. So we supposedly have a Python 2.7. Let's check one by one. Okay, 2.7, excellent. Here 2.7. Okay, exit. What else? Java minus version 1.7 or on top. Okay, we get 11 already. That's good. Linux machine that. And in order for us to check whether this is Unix, although this is very obviously Linux or Unix or Linux, we just typing this command, uname minus s. So this is Linux definitely, because Windows is not supporting, is not support for the SCTP. Okay, we will choose the GitHub.
Yeah, we will go to the GitHub, and this is the GitHub that I try to find. There are several things to find in the GitHub, but a lot of them is not really working properly. Okay, so I already found the best one, the good one, and it's smooth for me to configure it. So basically, you can find this here, Ethical Hacker Nidra 6.7 Ploid. We can use this one. Okay, we will just try to, what do you call this? To clone, okay guys? Sudo git clone. Okay, yeah, this is the address of the GitHub that we want to cloning. There's an object here, excellent, good, super. Okay, control shift ability. Now, okay, of course there is a client, but this client need to trigger to somewhere else, which is somewhere the component that always listen and capable to handle giving the expected response, and acting like a HLR in this case. So good thing is in these applications from the GitHub, they already prepare the server acting for like behave like a HLR in this case. But of course there are requirements that we need to configure it first. Testing server attack occasions. In this case, we will choose for this one is anytime interrogations. Okay, and you can find here in the README, right? Cat. Okay. So we need to add this to IP definitely. So I think I was done this before. I hope still okay, this one. So we need to append this IP. Copy selections. Pass to the report. Enter. Excellent work. This is work. Okay. Yes, why? Boom. Okay. These two IP I get it, of course, from here. This will be acting as my own, the one who acting as my client, the one who trigger the SS7 request GSM map using the anytime interrogations operations in the TS29.002, and this one will be the one who acting as a server. Of course, we need to configure this IP with those two comment, the one that I say just stated, I just type it for you with this one. Okay, and then next we need to switch on those Java, of course, from here. Right. Java minus jar. Always same mistake. Okay, initialize.
Okay guys, this is the scope of the part 1. Don't miss for the video part 2, it will come in the next week. And from there, we will execute together how to running the anytime interrogations, and we will go thoroughly what is the meaning of those messages. Okay guys, keep learning and stay humble. So if I play dead, will you regret everything that you did, that you said? I don't think you understand what you're doing, and my heart's black and blue from the bruising.
I feel like when I'm with you I'm losing. I feel like you think that this amusing. Sitting there gaslighting and confusing. Was it me?